Today, more and more of us work in teams, and more often than not, the people that we work with may be remote and spread across different geographies. Think of Microsoft 365 as a universal toolkit to enable teamwork, starting with tools built for teamwork using apps designed for easy file sharing and co-authoring experiences, to how we're making it easier for you to collectively get work done in teams based on your work and communication preferences, spanning modern email, calendar, and a connected chat-based workspace supporting calls, shared content, and online meetings. Then there are the tools to make your teams work broadly discoverable via your intranet and engage across teams in the organization via enterprise social. So we give you a broad toolkit, and these are all connected with a shared foundation of built-in security and compliance controls, discovery and intelligence via the Microsoft Graph, and Office 365 groups within Azure Active Directory. In the next few minutes, I'll cover the essentials for how we make this possible in Microsoft 365. We'll start in the Office 365 Pro Plus desktop apps, and I have Word open in this case. Here you can see I'm signed into Office 365 with all of my files linked on the left here from OneDrive and SharePoint. Now, these services are the foundation for enterprise content management, and saving to OneDrive and SharePoint enables the entire team to work on the same file at the same time. In this case, I'm going to go ahead and open a doc. And you can see up here in the upper right-hand corner, there's a share button there in all of the Office apps. In this case, I'm going to share with my group, in this case, the online marketing group. In doing that, we'll give everybody in that group permissions to be able to edit the document. Now, as I scroll down and start to view the document itself, we'll see that inside the doc are a couple of co-authors. We've got both Adele and Nestor on my team already in the doc and able to edit. Now let's switch to Outlook, and here you can see that I'm in my group inbox. I can see a cloud attachment in the bottom right-hand corner, and that keeps everything central as a single source of truth. And it's also more secure, unlike normal attachments. They can't be simply forwarded on, and when I cloud attach a file, every recipient's automatically given access. I can also see likes and at mentions. And these are really great because as you type an at sign, it automatically searches for contacts and adds them to the to line. Now, the other thing that you're going to see here is a shared calendar. This allows me to stay up to date with all of our team events, and we can also link to our shared files in SharePoint and even a shared OneNote. Microsoft Teams then provides a chat-based workspace that brings together all of the things that you work with on a continual basis with your teams. Now here, you can see all the teams, and you can see all the corresponding channels of grouped conversations underneath each team. And as I go in, I can see all the different tabs that I have inside of my team. Here I can see all the files stored in SharePoint. I can see also Power BI or my group plan. Now I'm just going to go ahead and go back into my conversations view, because in this case I want to attach a file and show how that uses SharePoint at the back end. I'm going to go ahead and attach this PowerPoint. And when we go into the files tab, we'll see that that file is available for me to get to later. And I can even go into the file and view it, or I can edit it all within the context of Teams. This also will enable me to be able to co-author on the file with my team. Now, let me show you a couple other things here. I can look at calls. In this case, I can even use PSTN integration to be able to do voice and video calling. I can see all of my meetings here in one place and join those meetings right directly from within Teams. So Teams really becomes the integrated hub for teamwork. Now, beyond day-to-day work with the people that you spend the most time with, SharePoint communication sites and Yammer support collaboration company-wide, cross-group, and cross-department. In this case here, I'm in a SharePoint communication site, and you can see all the events that I've linked to it, all the files. I'm going to go into a page, the program overview, and here we can see how easy it is to edit this page. So I'm going to go ahead and click Edit. Now, all these sites are composed of different web parts, and I'm going to go ahead and open up a web part and show how that's built. In this case, I've got a list of the things I can add to the page. You can see the different components I can do there. I'll expand that out, and you can see beyond text and images, we can do things like maps. We can do Microsoft Forms, Twitter. We can even do Power BI within the site itself. As I scroll down, I can see the rest of this page with maps and other rich content. And here's a Yammer conversation that's embedded directly in my SharePoint communication site. Now, if I open this directly in Yammer, you'll see that this is a really great place to communicate across my organization and crowdsource ideas and gather feedback. So those were user experiences and core technologies supporting teamwork and Microsoft 365. But let's switch gears and cover what you as IT admins need to do to be able to enable these capabilities. Now we'll start with planning and use the IT roadmap for Microsoft 365 to assess which services you have configured and the current tools and preferences that your users have for teamwork and collaboration. Now to do this, we'll click on the different services that correspond with teamwork and collab, meaning communication, meeting services, group collab, and internet and search. Now here you can see a continuum of four levels, and I'm gonna click on group collaboration services and then into the teamwork tab. And here we can see a continuum of the four levels of how we can implement teamwork services. And that's going to then let us select our future level that we want to get to. And by doing that, we can see all the different things that we need to work on to be able to implement those services. We'll then build a tailored and detailed IT roadmap action plan for moving from what you have to your future state. Now, moving to the Azure portal, remember that Azure Active Directory and Groups is really at the core of these teamwork experiences. So you're going to want to start getting Azure AD running if it isn't already. Considerations for groups and groups management are core to the administration tasks for teamwork. Moving into the Office 365 admin portal, the Office 365 Pro Plus apps can be deployed using your software distribution tools like System Center Configuration Manager. And for your Windows 10 devices, you can use Azure AD Join so that your PCs are capable of single sign-on into your managed Microsoft 365 services, even if they're not joined to your on-prem AD domain. Now, back in the Office 365 portal, you also have a number of options to configure the settings for Microsoft Teams. This includes options to tailor and lock down experiences such as how external guest contributors work within your Teams. And here's an early look at what's coming for Teams administration, including options for integrated voice and telephony management. SharePoint has a new admin center experience to manage your sites and site collections, security and compliance controls. And OneDrive administration lets you configure sharing controls and policies for internal and external users. In Yammer, you might want to manage who can use Yammer. For example, you may want to enforce Azure AD identities and that those are used. So moving on to security and compliance, the Security and Compliance Center in Office 365 is a central place to configure shared information protection policies, like data loss prevention, as well as governance and compliance controls for your files. And finally, you'll want to use Microsoft 365's usage reporting and Power BI content pack for usage analytics to track down how your users are leveraging tools for teamwork. So that was an overview of the teamwork experiences and corresponding admin considerations with Microsoft 365. To learn more, you can explore deeper learning experiences and get help and guidance in our hands-on labs, both online at the link shown or on site at our tech summits. Now be sure to check out the Microsoft 365 Teamwork playlist on Microsoft Mechanics to learn more about the topics I've covered today. Just about every tool and process I've shown here was explained in depth on a recent show or demo bench. Thanks for watching.